Hey, welcome to the new series about PlayFab service and how to integrate it with Unity. Let's jump right in. Firstly, you'll need to create a new PlayFab account, verify your email, and supply some basic info about your studio. As you can see, there's one auto-generated game already in our list. I think it's a good idea to modify its settings and give it a title. Click on My Game, then gear icon, and select Edit Title Info. Here you can change the name of your game. Okay, now let's jump into the Unity. I have a simple game called Jumping John. Yes, this is John. John jumps whenever a player presses the space key and hopes that you'll keep him alive as long as possible. If you'd like to see John in action, be sure to check our next videos in the series. Today, we'll focus only on connecting our game to PlayFab servers and to call a simple login method. Go ahead and grab PlayFab asset package from the link in the description. Then, import it into your Unity project by simply dragging it in. After a few seconds, you should be greeted with simple PlayFab login screen. Use Login option at the bottom and input your login password. After successful login, you should be prompt to install PlayFab SDK. Don't worry, everything is automated, so just press install button and wait a second for it to finish. Then, a bit of configuration. We need to choose which game you'd like to link. Click Set My Title, select your studio, and finally, your game title. Notice that developer's secret key should be filled out automatically for you. And finally, it's time to test our PlayFab integration. Create a new script called PlayFab Manager. Open it and add PlayFab and PlayFab.ClientModels namespaces. We will start with a new method called Login. Here, create a new request called Login with Custom ID request with Custom ID set to SystemInfo.DeviceUniqueIdentifier and Create Account Boolean set to True. To call PlayFab API, simply type PlayFab Client API dot login with custom ID and pass request parameters, success and failure methods. The last step is to type on success and on error methods that will output some useful debug information. Also, don't forget to call login method on start. Okay, and that's it. We'll attach our PlayFab login script to main camera to run it when the game starts. Finally, press play and watch for the console output. As you can see, console returns successful message, which means our game has successfully created an account in PlayFab service. As you might already notice, we haven't provided any login, email or password. That's because we've just used the most basic authentication option that creates anonymous accounts. In later videos, I'll talk about more advanced login options like logging in with email and password. Now, let's check if we can find newly created player in our admin dashboard. Go back to the browser, find your game title, click Players in the left sidebar, and press search. And look, here is our newly created player. That's it for today's video. Be sure to subscribe this channel for more future tutorials from PlayFab and Unity. See you around!